As we exclusively reported earlier this month, Samsung has officially launched the One UI 8.0 beta program. The latest beta version, built on Android 16, is now being rolled out to the Galaxy S25 series. Currently, the beta program is available in South Korea, with plans to expand to other regions where Samsung typically releases beta updates. Owners of the Galaxy S25, Galaxy S25 Plus, and Galaxy S25 Ultra in South Korea have begun receiving the Android 16-based One UI 8.0 beta upgrade. This update, identified by firmware version, and has a download size of approximately 3.3 gigs for the Galaxy S25 Ultra, although this may vary for different models. Additionally, it includes the May 2025 security patch. For now, the update is also set to be distributed in Germany, the UK, and the USA. While this new upgrade does not feature a significant UI overhaul unlike the transition to One UI 7.0, it does introduce a host of new and enhanced features. To enroll eligible devices in the One UI 8.0 beta program, users should download the Samsung Members app, log in with their Samsung account, and select the One UI 8.0 beta program banner on the main page. After completing the registration, users can navigate to Settings, Software Update, and then download and install. Once the download is finished, simply tap the Install Now button, and the device will restart after a few minutes to complete the installation. For guidance on preparing your Galaxy phone for the One UI 8 beta update, please refer to our detailed post. We will also publish the complete changelog for the One UI 8.0 beta update once Samsung makes it available, allowing users to review the modifications and enhancements included in this new version. Samsung plans to release additional beta versions periodically, and upon the conclusion of Samsung One UI 8, is also providing support for incompatible GoodLock apps. Beta testers have reported several issues to the moderators within the Korean community, and the app developers have officially acknowledged these concerns while providing an update on the GoodLock app. However, there is currently no information regarding a timeline for the completion of the development process. The lack of information stems from compatibility challenges that arise with each major software upgrade. Nevertheless, One UI 8 is currently undergoing testing, and it is expected to achieve compatibility upon its stable release. In a statement, the GoodLock team noted, "For customers who are curious about the availability of GoodLock in the One UI 8.0 beta, we will share updates on our progress. Here, you will find a list of GoodLock modules that are currently compatible with the One UI 8.0 beta program. 1. LockStar. 2. ClockFace. 3. Keyscape. 4. Theme Park. 5. Wonderland. 6. Edge Lighting Plus. 7. One Hand Operation Plus. 8. Dropship. 9. Galaxy to Share. 10. Routines Plus. 11. Nice Catch. 12. Edge Touch. 13. Sound Assistant. 14. Camera Assistant. 15. Register. 16. Display Assistant. 17. Nice Shot. These are the apps that are under development for One UI 8 support. 1. QuickStar. 2. NavStar. 3. MultiStar. 4. NoticeStar. 5. Home Up. 6. Game Booster Plus. We are working hard to make sure that all GoodLock apps will be available when One UI 8 launches, and we'll update you again as soon as preparations are complete, according to the GoodLock team. Now, let us take a detailed look at the 10 features we mentioned earlier. Additionally, I will share my own thoughts at the end of this video. 1. Updated One UI Home. With a Z, Y, F, One build, the home screen app, One UI Home, has been updated to version 17.0.00.127 from version 17.0.00.113. This will increase the functionality and appearance of the home screen. However, the actual features haven't been published yet, but we should expect smoother and better home screen functions. 2. App drawer spacing issue fix. Many users observed a peculiar issue with the app drawer in the initial beta. The space between apps and the search bar in the vertical list seemed weird. the latest Beta 2 release will purportedly fix this glitch. After this update, the app drawer will look better and regular again, just like it should. 3. Resolve widget scaling issue. With the next beta release, Samsung will improve the home screen widgets. Currently, the widgets are not scaling properly, making them look weird on the home screen. The next beta release guarantees that the widgets scale correctly and fit neatly on the screen. These are some of the adjustments and fixes that we may anticipate to see in the upcoming beta update. Some speculations claim that the One UI 8 Beta 2 upgrade could be arriving soon for the Galaxy S25 series. It might expand the One UI beta program to new nations. In addition, Samsung might add other Galaxy flagships, including the Galaxy S24 series, the Galaxy Z Fold 6, and the Galaxy Z Flip 6, to the One UI 8 beta program along with the release of Beta 2 update for the Galaxy S25 series. Stay tuned for additional details. 4. New Quick Share Experience. Quick Share has a redesigned experience on One UI 8 with discrete send and receive tabs. Users can now pick files to be transmitted over Quick Share via this interface, an alternative to the normal sharing menu. This change is likely to come to all Android devices via an upgrade to Google's version of Quick Share. 5. Files app makes it easy to find downloads. The My Files app has received a modest update, with categories now displayed at the top of the app and a dedicated Files added recently row showing samples of files that you generated on the device or downloaded. 6. Updated weather app. The weather app has been upgraded with new, more realistic people and visuals to reflect the weather conditions. The app also has more translucent UI components throughout its many decks. 7. Samsung Internet Menu. The Samsung Internet app has received an upgraded design that largely affects the overflow shortcuts menu. It makes sharing easier and also allows for shortcuts to be modified. 8. Split screen mode receives a OnePlus upgrade. Samsung now enables a 90-10 split for apps in split screen mode. This works by allowing you to tap on a section of the display to shift between apps. It works just like Open Canvas on OnePlus handsets, a feature first announced for foldables and tablets, and which has since spread to regular smartphones with nearly equal capabilities. Google is expected to integrate this similar functionality in Android 16 as a whole, but it's not yet live, just showing up in leaked builds. 9. Updated Reminder App Plus Calendar Management. Samsung has upgraded its Reminder app in some important ways, with new categories and suggested reminders. Meanwhile, the Samsung Calendar app can now create and manage reminders. 10. Calendar, manage reminders in calendar. You may quickly add reminders in the calendar app without visiting the reminder app. Whenever you hit the add button, you'll have the choice of adding an event or a reminder. You may also drag and drop reminders on your calendar to reschedule them. Add events quickly. When you start creating an event in the quick add menu, you'll get suggestions for event names and times based on your past events. Just tap one of the choices to add an event without additional input. So finally, here are my thoughts. Samsung, please make this change in One UI 8 Drawing Assist. Why hide the one item that lets you manipulate the AI more precisely? I have to be honest and say that I don't use most of what Galaxy AI has to offer very often. I don't utilize some capabilities, like Interpreter, at all. But I know that everyone will have a different experience with Galaxy AI. The two Galaxy AI functions I like the most are Drawing Assist and Generative Wallpaper. Samsung made Drawing Assist a lot better with the One UI 7 update, which is the last feature. It changed the tool's interface and added support for more than one mode of use. Samsung also created a sketch matching strength slider to allow consumers greater control over how their AI artworks turn out. And this happens to be what I want to talk about in this video. In case you don't know, you can utilize the slider Samsung included with the One UI 7 update to manipulate the AI and get quite diverse results from the same sketch, depending on how much you want the AI to reinterpret your original drawing. Here are four samples of the same crude sketch recreated by the AI at varying sketch matching strength settings. The higher the matching strength, the lower the AI involvement. The way I see it, the sketch matching strength slider has become a vital component of the Drawing Assist experience. It's not only interesting to experiment with different effects, but can also be something you may wish to modify from one sketch to another. Despite this, the option is tucked away behind multiple screens inside the Drawing Assist settings menu. It's a bit of a hassle to reach. You can access the slider by hitting the three-dot menu button in the upper right area of the Drawing Assist window, entering settings, and selecting sketch matching strength. Then you need to swipe back two times to take another try at a redraw with a different matching strength setting. As someone who likes to fire up Drawing Assist from time to time, I wish Samsung would bring this slider to the forefront with the One UI 8 upgrade. So Samsung, if you're seeing this, please consider providing us Drawing Assist enthusiasts quicker access to the slider. I think having it right on the main drawing screen, maybe above the six art style presets or the generate button, would be excellent. Even as a pop-out slider disguised behind a small dedicated button would be okay. One UI 8 testing is underway, but the public build will launch with the upcoming Galaxy Z Fold 7 and Galaxy Z Flip 7 foldable phones this summer. It should then start spreading out to additional phones as an OTA update. So, if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more exciting tech news and updates. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Goodbye and peace out.